Tonya. Straight into Andy Kotzka. Now Peter Petkovski away from Trdenic. Still Petkovski. Still by Tonya. Petkovski. Petkovski. Putting that one across. Oller and Shaw. Saved there by Pisano. Good break back from St George. Down the right hand touchline. United in the end by Tony Pisano.
Hagen was the ball here, Mike. Shaw on the first post when Hagen on the far post.
Steve O'Connor, certainly John. It's arguably a team seemed to have settled the quicker of the two.
Yes, they've been more impressive than what we've seen so far. Saints are really not enough happening for them in the middle of the park. It's been dominated by Apia.
Pedro Ricoy. Ethan Brown. Still Ricoy, now Kevin Hagen. Hagen with the shot. And St George have taken the lead. Kevin Hagen. The goal coming after 18 minutes. And Kevin Hagen, his sixth goal of the season. He hit that so sweetly. It was set up there by Pedro Ricoy. Kevin Hagen picked his spot and went outside the penalty area. Gave Tony Pisano no chance. But good work here from Pedro Ricoy. And good clinical finishing from Kevin Hagen. Up here, Leichhardt 0, St George 1. Shaw getting away there from defenders, needs some help. Jankos has got a cross, still Scott Oller and Shaw trying to play that one through. Hagen has made the run forward. Now Potier, Potier with the shot. And over the top there from Alan Potier. But Apia there completely exposed on the break from Scott Oller and Shaw on the far side. Oller and Shaw, they're trying to get that one across. Potier, bring the ball down. The shot there goes over the bar. Pushing the back on Scott Oller and Shaw. That was well spotted by the referee. Push. Richard Ransom was telling me he certainly enjoyed his trip to Chile. Must have done quite well to get the semi-final between Yugoslavia and East Germany. Some George supporters there in fine voice. Having a cheer about with their side leading by a goal to nil. Oller and Shaw. Scott Oller and Shaw twisting and turning. Oller and Shaw! And now they lead by 2-0. Scotty Oller and Shaw. The goal coming after 41 minutes. And Scott Oller and Shaw put St George further ahead. The free kick taken there by Steve O'Connor. And Scott Oller and Shaw twists and turns, makes that yard of space, and again beats Pisano, and this time from outside the penalty area with the assistance of the woodwork. But Scott Oller and Shaw. Clinical finishing, Apia Leichhardt 0, St George 2, with just about 3 minutes to go to half-time. Throw to St George, taken there by David Green. And then of everybody, a good run this from Pedro Ricoy, still Ricoy, Ricoy, 3-0! St George go further ahead, the goal coming right on the stroke of half-time. Didn't he take it well? But good quick thinking there from David Green. The long throw over the head of all the defenders. Pedro Ricoy, it was an awkward angle. But somehow he gets it past Pisano. And good finishing again from Pedro Ricoy. Pisano had no chance with that. As we come up to the half-time break. Apia Leichhardt 0, St George 3. Well, John.
Well, who would have picked 3-0? What a fabulous goal. Well thought out by David Green. Perhaps a bit of bad defending by Apia. But Ricoy had the choice to cross or shoot and made the right decision. Fabulous shot. And it's very difficult to see Apia coming back from three goals down.
Well, there is the half-time scoreline. And John, the finishing of Pedro Ricoy as we talk about that third goal. The angle was always awkward. He did so well.
Yes, a fabulous shot. Ricoy is one of the unsung heroes. When we talk of St George and young players, we tend to look at Oller and Shaw and so on, but they have so many good young players, and Ricoy is certainly one of them. As you said, he's only 20. Appears about to be around for ages, but a fabulous goal. But I would think at half-time, Saints coaches Frank Arrock and Odia Bonny would be the biggest problems to keep their players' feet on the ground. It's very hard when you're leading 3-0 and you think the game's all over. There's a long way to go. And I would think a lot of their efforts at half-time would be getting that fact through to the St George players.
Now Kotzka. Ollerenshaw. Hagen's available. Still Scotty Ollerenshaw. Jacken and Hagen. Potier. Phil Allen Potier. And just slide there from Potier. They were queuing up there from St George. Franco Rock knows how close that was to goal number four. The Arpia defence there was stretched. Hagen couldn't get a shot in, but Potier came bursting through. His shot finishes up wide. So Petkovski. Pedro Ricoy. Passed up by Vandalo. Still Ricoy. Suddenly by Butler. Now Parison. Strong young player, Tony Parison. Good battling play there. Getting away from Petkovski and Ricoy. Just picking up Viktor Zanic. Now Rod Brown. Trying the shot. He was nice enough for Hilton Phillips. Phillips gets the post. Gibson there was struggling. He knew very little about that. St George escape. And Pedro Ricoy. So 10 minutes gone in the second half. Arpia Leichhardt nil, St George 3. As this is Rod Brown. Scored 14 goals so far this season. Current member of the Wingfield Socceroos, former Australian youth international, who scored 14 goals in 17 appearances. Disappointment. The face there of Riley Rasic. Despite having an outstanding season, no one can take it away from them. They are the league champions. And they won that so well. Now Ollerenshaw. Ollerenshaw there. Shooting the ball well from Mark Brown. Potier. Now Pedro Ricoy. Still Ricoy. Away from Arno Bertoni. Ricoy! Opportunity there for number four. As we look at the West End National Soccer League Cup that will be presented to the winning side at the end of this match. Now Kevin Hagen. Still Hagen. Hagen! Surely now it's been put beyond any doubt at all. The goal coming 30 minutes into the second half. Kevin Hagen again. Well outside the penalty area, giving Tony Pisano no chance. I think one must say that there, Tony Pisano could have been unsighted. The ball was hit hard and low by Kevin Hagen. His second goal for the afternoon. Arpia Leichhardt 0, St George 4. Now Parison. Tony Parison. More thanks to the Zarpia side since he came on. Jankos. Tredenick. Trying to get that one in hard and low. Kotzka. Kotzka misses it. Gibson there to the rescue as Hilton Phillips was the player who was through. And Hilton Phillips, who scored when these two teams met on the opening day of the season, he also scored last week. There's a player there denied by Mike Gibson. Andy Kotzka here is the player who slips it through. There for Hilton Phillips. Connor. The offside flag this time stayed down. Fletcher there plays that one through. This is Zoran Ilić. Zoran Ilić! Touched away there by Tony Pisano. And Zoran Ilić, who's already scored one goal in the National Soccer League this season. That was against Preston in a 3-0 win.
Caught it in two minds, mate.
He nearly gets his name on the score sheet in the grand final, John. He got it through the legs of Pisano.
He went to pass it inside, changed his mind, decided to go himself.
He was looking to do a short corner. Some of the West End girls here this afternoon adding some glamour to the occasion. Now Potier. Potier! Against the bar. But Alan Potier, so close to making it five. The bar and away to safety. So all eyes now on referee Richard Lorenz. On our watch, we've played 60 seconds of stoppage time. Charlie Jankos, referee Richard Lorenz, checks his watch, and there's the final whistle. St George have won the 1987 grand final. Final scoreline, Apia Leichhardt 0.
We weren't tipped to win all season, and it's good to beat them.
Did you expect to fight back as well as you did from early on in the season? Everyone wrote you off bad.
It was a new squad, and it's going to take time to blend together, but I think Rocky and Kevin Hogan helped the team a lot.
I think Wednesday night was a telling factor. Extra time, and we just couldn't put it together today. We're just too tired. So
you can have a great year, but you can have one or two bad games, and it just takes away all the good that you've done this year. You know, there's a lot of disappointment over the year, but I guess, you know, one result doesn't make the season. And drink West End, it's good for you, Smelly Joe. And you know, one bad result doesn't make the season, but it's a disappointing result.
Yeah, mate, you'll be celebrating nevertheless all week long.
All week long, I'm celebrating tonight, then 9:45 flight to Noosa tomorrow morning, and I'll be going crazy.
St George travelled by bus to Parramatta Stadium, and they certainly left in a boisterous manner. But really, now I know why they're soccer players and not rock and roll stars. A comfortable 45-minute trip to the Budapest club, and why shouldn't it be? A 4-0 win over Apia doesn't happen every week, but a grand final victory is even sweeter. Back home, the boys found time to drink. The Chiggles were working overtime, while those hungry players were well catered for. Plenty of smiles, plenty of happy people, but the boys just wanted to sing. Well, it's been tough on the players this year. They certainly did the right thing at speech time.
Now, I'd really like to thank these people that are downtrodden all year. And they give us a bit of stick all year, but they're all here tonight. And that's our wives and girlfriends. They're really supporting us well during the year. So if you put your hands together for those people.
Unbelievable. I couldn't believe they won by 4 goals. It's fantastic. We thought they'd win all the time, though.
What about Steve, the big rock? Is he going to play on again next year?
I think so. I think he's very happy where he is. He's played great this year, too. It's really brought out the best in him.
It was a great game with 4 brilliant goals, and one of those was scored by Pedro Ricoy.
Pedro Ricoy, I know I've only had about 2 or 3 beers. I say you've had about 8 or 9. How does it feel?
Great. It feels great to be champions, the true champions, I might add. Hopefully we'll have a good season next year too.
Can you tell us about the goal, mate? Tell us about the goal.
It was a planned move, actually. A superstar came off the line. I saw the top corner and I just shot for it and went in.
The drinks were overflowing on the night. However, Mrs. Alan Portier was more content to say good day to her friends in Perth. In between all this, there was a shock announcement.
Tuesday, we will be training at the normal time of 5 o'clock.
Are you serious?
Yes. By Mr. Frank Arrow, Tuesday, training. Joke. No joke. See there.
The way the boys drank, I don't think they'll be at training tomorrow. There were a few speeches on the night, and Captain Andy Koska couldn't hold himself back.
Seriously, I think that everyone that was out of the game today would like to especially thank the boys for a tremendous effort. 4-0 in the grand final, something special. And we really had one special reason to win today, and as Idy Abonnie was telling us before the game, Apia is a very ugly side. And I'm sure you saw that when they ran out, so any team that ugly doesn't deserve to win the championship.
Overall, a great night celebration, which I'm told finished around 4 this morning, the culmination of a big year for the Saints.